My name is Kyle, and I am a Godzilla fan. I love nothing more than watching giant monsters duking it out and smashing buildings to rubble, generally terrorizing the cities of Japan. For myself and a lot of my fellow fans, kaiju movies are more than just cinematic entertainment, they are an obsession. This obsession nudged me into starting a podcast about giant rubber monsters, and it's mostly thanks to this podcast's audience that I can make this documentary. This year marks the 60th birthday of Japan's most well-known kaiju, the King of the Monsters, but we all know him best as Godzilla. In addition to enjoying the hell out of these films, I have long been fascinated by the arduous process that Godzilla's filmmakers have had to endure to bring these monsters to life. The suits, the miniatures, the effects, and the personalities involved. But one aspect of the genre I have never had the opportunity to dive into, how do the Japanese perceive Godzilla? It's been 10 years since Japan made a Godzilla movie. Do they think there's a place for traditional and practical special effects in today's movie landscape? For these answers, I knew where I had to go. A little place called Tokyo, Japan. Thanks to spending a huge amount of time online talking to a myriad of monster fans, I've met some amazing people that share my love of the genre. But there's one fan I know who, like myself, was inspired to create his own program. Brandon runs Tokyo Toy Fiend, a YouTube channel that focuses entirely on hunting and tracking down toy stores in Tokyo. He and I had been chatting before the trip about how Japan is celebrating the King's 60th birthday, so I asked him to show us what was happening during our visit. We met in Roppongi, an area of Tokyo well known for its international appeal. It was here, specifically in the Tokyo Midtown, that a large Godzilla statue had been erected. This is the new American Godzilla, of course, only viewable for a couple of months to coincide with the opening of the film in Japan. And while it would have been nice to see the return of the classic Japanese monster, it was impressive nonetheless. Hey Brandon, what's up, dude?
Hey buddy, how you doing?
Dude, good to see you.
Good
how you been?
You. Fantastic.
This is amazing.
Yeah, right? Tokyo has a lot of awesome stuff going on right now to do with Godzilla. There's actually a really awesome Yuji Kaida exhibit at Tokyo Tower.
That would be a badass. I would really like to see that.
Let's go check it out, man.
All right. From Roppongi, we hopped on the subway towards one of Japan's most well-known landmarks. The Tokyo Tower stands 333 meters tall, and in 1958, it was the tallest man-made structure in the world. Year-round, this is one of Tokyo's most popular tourist destinations, but for us, it's best known as a punching bag for our favorite monsters. The first beast to topple this tower wasn't Godzilla, but the larval form of Mothra in the original 1961 film.
It's good to see, like, such an iconic location in, you know, kaiju films.
That's the beautiful thing about being in Japan in general.
Of course.
Like, anywhere you turn, it's been in a movie.
Yeah.
You know,
well,
so.
This was in three major movies, yeah, Mothra, King Kong Escapes, and the Gamera, first Gamera film.
Yeah.
Gamma reboot film, I should say.
We checked out the Godzilla Generation exhibit in the lobby of the tower. There was a small display showing stills and charts about the new Godzilla film, but where was the tribute to the classic? I guess it's understandable the Legendary Pictures version is showcased. They want to sell those tickets. Still, it was interesting to see the new juxtapositioned against the vintage photos and displays of Tokyo Tower's rich history. The real treat from this exhibition was on the third floor, and while I would love to show you the works that were on display from internationally known kaiju enthusiast and brilliant artist Yuji Kaida, there were, unfortunately, rules about what can and cannot be filmed or photographed. Seeing Kaida's artwork on display was quite inspiring, and if we weren't on a pretty tight schedule, I think I may have fallen victim to the temptation of leaving the tower with a large bag filled with goodies. As it stands, I have a modicum of willpower, so we made our way to Akihabara to check out Brandon's specialty, toy shopping.
All right, man, I know we're in Akihabara, but Akihabara isn't just a section of town. You gotta tell me a little bit about why I'm seeing what I'm seeing here.
Pretty much, it is the nerd mecca, if you will, of the world. I mean, you come here and get anything you want, toy-wise, vinyl, video games, Gundam, anything you want is here. It's like, remember on Pinocchio where they went to the Forbidden Land? This is what I picture in
this
real
is
life.
The forbidden,
forbidden
Land.
Forbidden Land from Pinocchio, yeah. So this is what I would categorize it as, you know.
So. Nice, nice. So, what are some of your favorite shops here in town, in Akihabara?
Obviously, Mandaraki. It's like, you know, the motherland for everybody from the United States or around the world who wants anything vinyl or anything in general. I mean,
this is the one that has like multiple floors,
yeah,
right?
I think it's five floors.
Oh my
five
god!
Five floors, yeah. Yes,
all right.
It's amazing.
Well, I want to hit that for sure.
Cool.
But before we go, tell me a little bit about like why you live in Japan. Why are you here in Tokyo?
I'm here in Tokyo because I'm a military, and I came to Tokyo. I lucked out and came where I've always wanted to come.
So you're stationed here.
Yes, for at least two more years. So,
oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, so I get to, you know, hit up all the conventions, and I live in this wonderland 24/7, so I get to get anything that you guys want in the States. So.
Without having to pay a ton of money for
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
What is it like being a kaiju fan here in Japan? I mean, we've already seen, you know, the big Godzilla statue, mm-hmm. and there's something going on in, you know, the Tokyo Tower right now, and as far as a toy collector, too.
Oh, man, and you know, the cool thing about Japan is there's always something going on all the time, like Godzilla-wise or kaiju-related.
Right.
You might not hear about it in the States, but there's always something going on. Like, you can come out here on a Wednesday sometimes, randomly, and just run into an awesome exhibit you never even knew was there.
Kaiju, you know? Wednesday?
Yeah,
that
Kaiju
sounds
Wednesday,
like my kind of
Kaiju
thing.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday,
I
any
like
day
it.
You want. It's Kaiju Day.
That's awesome.
So,
how has being here affected your collection?
It's affected my wallet more than it's affected my collection adversely. But it's awesome, man, because everything that, you know, in the States, it's really hard to get anything from Japan.
Right.
And if you don't want to pull a teeth and lose an arm to buy something, it's really rough, as everybody knows in the States.
It happens.
But here, you can just go to a hobby off or anywhere and, you know, hit the jackpot any day.
That's awesome.
So yeah, my collection's stepped up a little bit, and my wallet stepped down a lot of it. But hey, it's a win-win.
Win-win.
Okay. Yeah.
So you want to go win-win and check out Mandarake?
Let's go do it, dude.
All right. Cool. I like it.
As the sun started to dip into the west, we found ourselves facing an 8-story building that was the home to the Electronic District's branch of Mandarake, a sort of secondhand store that caters to just about every kind of otaku. That, of course, includes kaiju nerds like ourselves. The top two floors are stocked from floor to ceiling with nothing but toys upon toys. Thank goodness I have such a narrow focus for my nerdery. To really explore Akihabara would take an entire day, hours we didn't have during this visit. So after making our way through the narrow aisles of Mandarake, we decided to call it a day. After all, we had to get an early start the next morning. The next day, we found ourselves in a small residential section of the city to visit this man. Meet Shinpei Hayashiya, the man behind the highly sought after, by American fans at least, Gamera 4 Truth. I have never met a more outgoing Japanese man. His creativity is off the charts, his sense of humor is contagious, and the cherry on top is his huge love for Japanese monsters. I truly feel honored to share that same fanaticism. Making a singular kaiju film wasn't enough for Hayashiya. In total, he's made 4, and currently he's working on his 5th. Clearly, this is a man whose love for Godzilla and kaiju drives him to create works in an atmosphere currently devoid of what he wants to see. You've got to admire that kind of drive.
Hayashiya-san, thank you for letting us into your home.
Yeah.
Why did you make Gamera 4?
Gamera 4 を作った理由? 作った理由はね、ガメラ、平成シリーズ、1、2、3、3の終わり方に納得ができなくて、それできっとガメラ4が作ってもらえると思ってたの。あの続きがね、あの続きが作ってもらえると思って待ってたんだけども、全然作ってくれなくて、でもうあれで終わりだっていうことになってたんで、じゃあ自分で作ってみようかなって。
That makes sense. I mean, that was a cliffhanger ending. So, how was the reception here in Japan? Did people like it?
もう日本のファンはすごい喜んでくれた。始まってね、僕のガメラ4が始まって5分で、みんな泣いた。Crying.
Right. But you also did Godzilla vs. Death Gira?
あ、デスギラス。ゴジラとデスギラスはなぜ作ったかっていうとね、監督ゴジラ対、メガギラスの監督が手塚さんっていう監督で、僕と同い年だったの。で僕と同い年で、であとうとう僕と同い年の人がメジャーなゴジラ映画を撮るようになったんだなって思って、そのお礼の意味を込めて、パロディーゴジラを作った。パロディーゴジラ、デスギラスを作って見せたら監督さんが大喜びしてくれて、でそれをロフトプラスワンっていうライブハウスでやったんで、お客さんも喜んで、そのお客さんが次は何を撮りますかみたいな、その言われて、次はじゃあガメラの続き撮っちゃおうかなって言っちゃったんだよね。それがきっかけ。
So you're a big Godzilla fan, clearly. Big kaiju fan.
そうですね。ゴジラも子供の頃からね見てるから、もう当たり前のようにそのゴジラはね、ゴジラの映画っていうか、子供の頃からゴジラはもう当たり前のようにあったんで、いつ好きだって言われても子供はみんな好きだったんじゃないかな、男の子はね。で怖かったし、ゴジラはね、ゴジラ怖い、強い、子供はやっぱ憧れるよね。で僕の場合はもうおもちゃが大好きで、ゴジラをもう手元に置いときたかった、こういうのね、ゴジラで。なかなかその頃、僕が子供の頃はゴジラのおもちゃがあんまりなくて、でだからきっと大人になったらこういう風に集めて、で映画も作っちゃいたくなったんでしょうね。
Do you know Tezuka?
手塚さんはね、本当にゴジラ映画が好きなんで、で念願かなってゴジラを撮った人なのね。その東宝に入って、でやっとゴジラが作れるようになって、でゴジラ対デスギラス、ゴジラ対メカゴジラ、を作って、本当に幸せだったんだろうね。その気持ちがすごい映画に表れてて、でましてや同じ年なんで、同じ年の人がゴジラ撮るんだったら俺も撮りてえなって思ってたけども、やっぱりね、全然違う落語家だから、だから自主映画をどんどん撮るようになった。
Tell me a little bit more about Rakugo. I don't think many Americans know about this traditional Japanese performance.
アメリカの、コメディはスタンドアップコメディでしょ。日本は、トラディショナル落語、座布団、なんだ、座布団の上に座って落ち着いて話す。内容は江戸時代とか、大正、明治の頃の人間の生活を描く、コミカルに描いてる。でそういうのが、なんだろうな、喋ったことが、その聞いてる人たちの頭の中に浮かんで、それが笑いを生むっていう、だ映画とは全く違うスタンスのものに惹かれた。落語ストーリー&一番長いのは、 1時間20分ぐらい。
もう映画と同じ、喋る映画。 You're just speaking the whole time.
Speaking movie.
Speaking movie.
でも見てもきっと座って喋ってるだけだから、とっても地味に見えると思うんだけども、でもその世界がわかると、もう面白くてしょうがないと思います。
When did you use this for your performance? When did you start making Godzilla?
これはなんだろう、ガメラ砲を作ってる時に、日本の自衛隊に行って、戦車を取りたかったんですよ、自衛隊のね。で、協力をしてもらうのに、慰問に行きました。自衛隊に慰問に行って、落語を披露して、その時に、これを被って、自衛隊はほら、ゴジラ映画にいっぱい出てくるから、ゴジラ持ってたら喜ぶかなと思って。そしたらもうバカウケ。
With Raigan Riego and the new Gilala film and Gehara, is Japan just going to be making funny comedy kaiju films? Or do you think we'll ever see the serious Godzilla film again?
面白くはならないと思う。シリアス。アメリカのゴジラがシリアスだから、日本はそれを追っかけると思う。日本のファンはね、あの怪獣映画は真面目に見たい人が多い。怪獣映画が、その物語がふざけてると、ちょっとみんな嫌だなと思うんだよね。 この演技とかそういうのは真面目に怪獣映画を捉えてる日本人のファンは、日本人の人はね、真面目なんで、その怪獣っていないものじゃという、世の中に。世の中にいないものを真面目にいるっていうような物語じゃないと、やっぱりちょっとなんか違うんだよね。で、僕は落語家なんで、怪獣の部分はシリアスに撮るけども、人間ってもっとファニーなもんで、人間はもっと楽しいもんで、 怪獣が戦ってたら結構笑っちゃうし、そういうところをもっと出していきたいな。So
is your next film? Is that going to be funny or serious?
次の映画はね、怪獣はシリアスです。怪獣 is serious and drama is funny.
Well, that's awesome. I love seeing everything you have around here. You have one-of-a-kind items, so many one-of-a-kind items here.
Kaiju映画は本当に楽しんで見れて、なんだろうな。いないものを楽しむ。その怪獣って世の中にいないから、それをいるように楽しんで、その怪獣と人間が戦うのは、 とっても面白いことで、ゴジラだっていないけども、いたら楽しいなって思うし、いたらやっぱ戦いたいだろうなって思うし、特に、なんだろうな、やっぱり夢だよね。Where
do you see kaiju films going in the next, you know, decade? Or are you going to see more films made by Toho, Nigatsu, Karakawa? Or do you think everything's independent?
怪獣映画はね、日本ではあんまり商業的には儲からない。日本のマーケットが小さいんで、その見る人がマニアだけだと、その制作費が賄えないでしょ。で、やっぱり、でも、その自主映画で怪獣撮るって人は本当に少ない。もうみんな、等身大ヒーロー、その、 何、仮面ライダーみたいなとか、なんとかレンジャーっていう、そういうのは作りやすいけども、怪獣はテクニックがいっぱい必要なんで、怪獣映画を撮るには。だから、自主の人もやっぱり少ないよね。だけど僕は怪獣映画を新しいのが見たいから、自分が作らないと新しいの見れないなって思ってるんで、だから作る。Well,
I hope we could just continue seeing kaiju movies, even if they're independent films like your own, because somebody's got to keep it alive for the future generations, at least.
一番望むことはね、日本の、あの怪獣が大好きな監督さんが、アメリカの資本で アメリカのスタッフを使って怪獣映画を作ったら、もう世界ナンバーワンのができると思う。
Maybe someday you'll find your American director.
Here's the staff.
These guys here, yeah.
本当に分かってる人が作んないと、あの日本の怪獣映画の良さを分かってくれる人と、そのアメリカのスタッフが結集したら、本当にすごい怪獣映画が撮れると思うね。
Well, I'm glad that you, you let us into your house. I'm very happy to see your collection, and thank you for making the movies that you make. And I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
After thanking Hayashiya for welcoming us into his home, we said our goodbyes and made our way to Nakano Sun Plaza for our next meeting. Toho, the company famous outside of Japan for the Godzilla series and a number of other monster movies, employed a roster of actors that appeared in numerous entries in the series. We had a chance to sit down with a handful of these actors and get their perspective on Godzilla's impact. Yukiko Kobayashi was cast by Godzilla director Ishiro Honda in one of his last non-sci-fi films, but if you're watching this documentary, you probably know her best for her role as Kyoko in Destroy All Monsters. Akira Kubo stepped into the kaiju scene almost 10 years after the first Godzilla film, but made a big impact in movies like Son of Godzilla and Destroy All Monsters. Additionally, he played Tetsui Terry in my favorite film, Godzilla vs. Monster Zero. Yoshio Tsuchiya, one of Kurosawa's favorite actors, was also part of this roster. Tsuchiya has played many memorable characters in 5 Godzilla pictures, but is no stranger to giant monsters. Watch for him in movies like The Mysterians, Frankenstein Conquers the World, and Space Amoeba. Akira Takarada played Ogata, the male love interest in the first Godzilla film. That film's success solidified him as a leading man during the height of Japanese cinema. He returned to play a number of characters in 5 more of Godzilla's movies, including Godzilla vs. The Thing and Godzilla Final Wars.
How has Godzilla impacted your careers individually over the last 60 years?
まあ私がまさに60年前にあの東映に入って3本目の映画がこのゴジラのリーディングアクターとしての仕事をもらったわけですけれども、最初はどんな作品になるのかみんな手探りの状況でして、ただ一つ確かなことは、この作品のバックボーンとして、つまり社会的なそういうその背景として、日本は広島長崎でアトミックボーンの被害を受けました。それは放射能の脅威ですね。それから9年経って第五福竜丸がビキニ環礁で、アメリカの水爆実験によってこれまた被害を受けた、西に沈んだ太陽が数時間のうちにまた西から強烈な太陽が昇ったぞという船員の方々のそういう生々しい証言があるように大変恐ろしい火柱が立って、それから数時間後に、まあ、白い、まあ、パウダーみたいなメリケンコみたいな、それがまさに死の灰だったわけですけども、それをかぶって命からがら静岡の港に帰ってきたわけですね。でその後尊い船員の方々の数名の命が亡くなった、そういうふうなもので時代背景としてはあったわけですね、この作品を作るにあたって。で、東宝もあるいは田中裕子プロデューサーもやっぱり日本人が世界に向けてアナウンスというか、つまり警告を発することができるのはやっぱり核の被害を被った日本の国としてですね、当然、それに対して、まあ、発信しなければいけないという思いで空想上のゴジラなるものを誕生させて、で彼自身もはっきり言ったらディストロイヤーじゃなくて、彼自身もですね、まあ、洋上で、核の放射能の洗礼を受けて、彼自身の体の中にも放射能が蓄積されて、で、まあ、上陸してきたら彼ももって自らこう放射能を発するような体になってきたわけ で僕はそのですからこれはその単なるモンスターといいますか怪獣がですね、ただその都市を壊すというだけじゃなくて、それはまあはっきり言ったら人間に対する一つのアラームっていうか、 そういうものをあの発する一つの媒体ではなかったかな、そう思って、まあ、全員撮影に臨んだわけですね。
僕はね、ステージアクターだった。俳優座っていうところのね。で、僕、七人の侍っていうのはセブン侍、黒沢明。それで僕が映画に初めて出た。これは初めてもらった、ね、そして1年撮影が1年以上かかった。その半分ぐらいやってる時にゴジラという、ゴジラなんだろうと思って、好奇心が強いから、ゴジラって誰に聞いても分かんない、気取って言った人がいた、 G 作品だって。そうですね、それってなんだ G 作品ってなんだ、それって宣伝部に呼んで、ゴジラってなんだって聞いたら、ゴリラとキングコングね、ゴリラとクジラを合わせたようなもんだっていう、ますます分かんなくなっちゃった。そしたらどうしても見たくなった。これが七人の侍の半分ぐらい撮った頃、耳に入った。そして円谷さんのとこ行った、円谷ディレクター。そしたら、えへへへなんて笑っちゃってね。そしてね、見たゴジラを、何の恐竜じゃないのね。ところが恐竜ってのは、円谷さん尻尾上がってるよ、そしてつま先出しだよ。ところがゴジラはベタ足、象と同じでこうだ、恐竜はこれだね、こうやって尻尾。ところがその尻尾とベタ足がいいなと思ったの、僕は。それでね、こういうの出たいなと思ったけど、僕は黒沢映画やってたから我慢した。そしたら宝田君が出たんだね、これはゴジラ第一号、よかったね。ゴジラはいくつもある、いくつもあるけども、最初のゴジラってのがなぜかやたらいいね。円谷さん尻尾引きずるってのはおかしいと思うんだけど、なんて生意気言っちゃって、そんなことが楽しくてね、早く七人の侍が終わって、おそらく第二や第三を作るんじゃないかって言って、ミスター宝田羨ましかった、うん、好奇心強いから。そして黒沢さんが七人のやっと侍がセブンさんが終わったら、ゴジラも終わった。そして二つが同じ昭和29年1954年かに一緒に上映された。 それでね、面白くてね、いつか出たいと思ったけど、黒澤明という人はうるさい人で、僕にいちいち次に出るものは何に出るか言え、そしてお許しが出ないと出られない。ところがゴジラは本田イノセン本田一郎ディレクター、これが黒沢と本田一郎さんは兄弟アシスタントディレクターだった。それで兄弟のように仲良かった、だから OK。 それで初めてゴジラに出て。
ゴジラの何の映画、逆に質問なんですか、私一番最初出たの何ですか、ゴジラの息子かな。
Kubo-san's first Godzilla movie was Kaiju 大戦争。
Kaiju 大戦争。
Kaiju 大戦争。It's my favorite Godzilla movie actually.
Kaiju 大戦争。
Kaiju 大戦争。
Kaiju 大戦争。
あれも
Kaiju 大戦争。Kaiju 大戦争。Kaiju 大戦争。はい。
はい。はい。X 星人。
僕ら3人とも Kaiju 大戦争出てんだよ。
出てんだ。
When I found out who we had here, I said, oh, it's very good because Takarada-san, Kubo-san, Tsuchiya-san were in Kaiju Daisenso, and Kobayashi-san, Kubo-san, and Tsuchiya-san were in Destroy All Monsters, Kaiju Shoshengeki. All
together. Right. Oh. So
all have worked. ニック・アダムス
が出たのは怪獣。ニック・アダムスと
僕が一緒に出たの
は怪獣。
いや、今の俺 X 星人だった。怪獣
大戦争？うん、うん。はい。Fuji and Glenn. Glenn. ニック・アダムスと Planet X.Where Tsuchiya-san tricked you.
そう、あれなんかね、町の発明家とかなんとか言ってね。
あ、そうだそうだ。
あんたはエクス星人。
あ、そうだ。エクス星人。
こんなこんなこと言って、うーって言って、なんとかはなんとかなんとか。
こんなことやってドア開けたりね。
そうですね、ゴジラの映画は、私、東方の俳優養成所。半年間その養成所があるんですけど、その後もちょっとして間もなく怪獣送信劇オールモンスターズでデビューということでデビューしたんですけど、まだその時はもう何も演技もいろいろ撮影所のこともわからなくで撮影に入ってしまって、もう毎日毎日がもう新しいものを見て現場に行くことがやっぱり楽しくて、で本当に何にもわからないままですけど毎日毎日楽しく、最初はちょっとゴジラの映画どういう風になるのかしらと思って、でゴジラがそのものがいないので特撮と本こちらの撮影は別に撮るので目線とか本物がいないあちらの高いとこ見てくださいとか、で あんな高いとこにいるんだと目線を見るともうちょっと上ですとか、でどういうふうに全部出来上がるとなるのかしらと思って完成の映画を見ましたら、本当に特撮と私たちの撮った実写を合わせて、ああこんなにやっぱり作品がいい作品が出て一緒にいるように出来上がるんだわと思って、とてもそれは衝撃でした。で私は2本映画出させていただいたんですけど、もう間もなく私は女優生活をやめてしまったので、今になるとその2本でっていう作品ゴジラの映画に出させていただいたっていうことが今になるとすごく宝物、私の人生の宝物になってとっても幸せ、今とても幸せです。こうやってお話しさせていただくのもとっても幸せを感じてます。
I'm surprised you can wear earrings after, after Destroy All Monsters, after Kaiju Shoshigeki. It's very painful to watch as a viewer.
もう久保さんに、久保さんにピッて取られて、ふっ、あーって血がありましたね。血がもう、っていう感じで。もうそれで洗脳されてるわけですよね。これつけられて、そうです。皆さんすごく痛そうだって言ってくださってます。はい。
とにかくね、怪獣もいわゆるゴジラっていうのは面白いですよね。まあそう言っちゃなんだけど、私はね当時に一番学校も行ってましたしね、仕事と学校と両方でものすごい忙しかったのね。自分のスケジュールがね。だからあんまりその怪獣ってはっきり言ってですね、あんまり知らないし興味なかった、うん、だけど出てみるとねやっぱりねこのあれゴジラだってね、それどういう表情をするかみたいなね、そういう楽しさっていうか面白さがありましたね、だからそれまでは、まあ、なんていうか青春の文芸ものですか、私はね東方のそんな映画ばっかりやってたんで、いわゆる怪獣映画っていうのなんだろうなと思ってたのね、うん、でも後半になって出て、まあ、やっぱり一緒にこの芝居して監督の言う通りこうやるとね楽しかったですよ、とにかくね楽しかったって思い出が一番強いですね。
こと、シカゴ行ったんだ。その時に第一号のハリウッドゴジラやって僕に見せた。その時僕は見てつまらないと思った。わざわざ何もゴジラなんて権利を東方から買ってやることはないと思った。それに CG、 あのコンピューターグラフィックばっかりだ、ね、ところが東方のゴジラは手作りだ。一生懸命手作りでそういうことはやってない。それをアメリカ人が一番喜んでる。それが分かった、うん、へえと思ったけど、ひげをしろって言うから映画が終わって数日経って、これはゴジラじゃないって、何も東方にお金払ってやらなくたって、イグアナかなんか台変えた方がいいって言ったら、観客がゴジラゴジラジャパニーズゴジラってスタンドあれになった。はあ、その時思った。子供の頃見たゴジラが面白いと思った。その子供が大人になったね、子供を連れてまた見に行った。その子供がまた大人になって子供を連れてゴジラ見に行った。そういう歴史があったんだ、ゴジラには、うん、それが世界中に愛されてるっていうことだと思う。
もうあの皆さん言ったように、まあゴジラははっきり言ってまあ大変魅力的というかチャーミングだという、それから時々こう人間的に言えば喜怒哀楽のその愛と言いましょうかね、その悲しげな自分の誕生のこの宿命みたいなものを背負ってきてる。で、単なる破壊者ではないっていうことを、それと、何て言いましょうか、そのまあアメリカでキングコングがこうやってこの小さなフィギュアでこう少しずつやれて、エンパイアステートビルディングを登って一コマずつ撮っていった時代からは、もう長い歴史の中でいろんな面であの特殊撮影というのはこう進歩してきましたけども、やっぱり日本の持ってきたこのゴジラっていうものは日本人しかできなかったこの手作りの良さと言いましょうかね、匠っていう言葉が日本にはあるんですけれども、まさにその人たちが作った産物じゃないかなと思います。いくら金をかけてそれで CG を駆使してもなかなかそこの日本のゴジラの聖域に入ってこられないんじゃないかなっていう気がします。しかし世界的に大ヒットしたことは大いにアプローズを送りたいところですけれども、私はもう一つこの今こういったゴジラの生い立ちから考えると、私はそのゴジラっていうならその神が使わした聖なる獣、まあ聖獣というんですかね、日本の言葉では、まあ、そんなふうに思えてしょうがないんですね。だからこの破壊者と思われているゴジラが地上に現れないにするためには、まあ、2つ方法があると思います。例えばそうですね、もう地球上でですね、核戦争で本当地球が滅亡するぐらいに人間が愚かな戦いをしてしまえばですね、もうゴジラの出番はないわけです。それともう一つは違った方法で、地球がですね平和で平和で平和を目的として、みんなそのつまりいさかいがのない平和な世界を作ればもうゴジラも出てくる余地はないと、この2つのどっちを選択するかは人間の知恵にかかってるわけで、果たしてどっちがいいと思われますかね、こう観客もね、まあ、そんなふうに思いますね。私は神が使わした聖獣だと言っても過言ではないと思ってます。
I know we have to end the interview, but I really, really want to thank you all for being hereAnd I hope you enjoyed yourselves and enjoyed being able to speak with one another. And thank you very much.
We really enjoyed it. Thank you.
After the signing, we were lucky enough to be invited to a buffet dinner during which the actors wished our production the best of luck, and we were even toasted by Takarada.The catalyst for both this trip and the documentary was the big Godzilla special effects exhibition being held in Tokyo's Ikebukuro district, It was a gorgeous celebration of Godzilla's history, attended by fans young and old, and an absolute treat to see. It was truly indescribable to stand inches away from the actual monsters. They were right there. As I stared at these bulky costumes, I thought about the actors inside and the horror stories I've heard about them being hit with all too powerful pyrotechnics, almost drowning in the water scenes, their inability to last more than a few minutes in the suits before passing out of heat exhaustion and lack of oxygen. Not only did we get to see this incredible display of Godzilla memorabilia, I got to spend some obligatory cash in the gift shop. And at the end of the exhibit, we were treated to an appearance by Godzilla himself, stomping his way through the hallway outside, almost as if he was bidding us farewell, thanking us for coming out to celebrate his birthday. Okay, it was just good timing. That kind of makes it even more special. Our next stop was quite a trek, so we hopped on a train and made the long journey to meet a group of kaiju fans that have dedicated a lot of their free time and financial resources to learning how to make their own monster suits and puppets in the traditional ways of Japanese special effects, aka tokusatsu. This team comprises Kokubunji Studios. Their actual work area wasn't ready to receive guests, so we met them in a community center. But fear not, they brought along some pretty impressive projects. I remember the first time I saw Takao Yoshiba's Godzilla costume online because my jaw hit the keyboard. What you're looking at is without a doubt the most accurate representation of Godzilla's design from the classic Mothra vs. Godzilla, or as it's known here in the States, Godzilla vs. The Thing. Sure, we're talking about a fan-made piece of work, but after seeing the real thing that morning, you'd be hard-pressed to find the flaws that would separate it from what would have been made for a legitimate film. I was surprised to find that this group really just sets out to make the suits in order to learn the methods of yesteryear, and not to make films with them. And while the suit is more than impressive to have hanging from a heavy-duty metal frame, it would be a crime against Godzilla fans for me not to have asked for this.
Ghidra, the three-headed monster, battles Godzilla for mastery of the world. Men quake before the terror of their unleashed fury. All new, all never to be forgotten, a new high in screen terror.
That, my friends, was awesome. I mean, really impressive work, and to be quite honest, it looks like a lot of fun. Maybe I'm just nuts, though. We had one more stop to make before dinner to the landmark that no giant monster fan visiting Japan should pass up. I'm talking about Toho Studios. My photographer Dave had never been here before, and I wanted to make sure that he at least had a chance to see this iconic spot before heading back to America.
It's amazing, man.
Yeah, man.
Absolutely amazing.
You can't come to Japan to film a documentary about the King of the Monsters without actually making it to Toho, right?
Right. I mean, the last time we were in Japan, we did not get to see this. So this is my first time, and I can't tell you how excited I am to be here.
That's awesome. Yeah, I've been to Toho before, but this is the first time I've seen this Godzilla mural. This is another one of those events that they had this year to promote the 60 years of Godzilla, and it's gorgeous.
It's gorgeous. It's totally gorgeous. I'm almost speechless when I walked up to it and turned that corner and you saw it just looming there bigger than life.
Nice.
It's just really awesome.
So is this like a big culmination of all of your life's events of being a kaiju fan?
Man, Kyle, it totally is. I mean, when I was a little boy, much like many other Godzilla fans, I was fascinated with dinosaurs.
Oh yeah.
So one day my dad circled this movie in the TV guide called Monster Zero. I had no idea what it was, but he said, I think you're gonna like this. So I watched it, and I was just spellbound, and the rest is history.
That's rad.
And for me, to be part of this documentary, to, you know, fulfill my four favorite things, photography, travel, yep, Japan, and of course, Godzilla. You know, it's just like all of the stars were aligned for this, so. I'm just like, I'm almost speechless.
Cool. Man, I'm really glad you came along. I'm really glad that we've had this time. We've had some really amazing things happen.
We have.
And I like those guys at Kokobunji Studio were fantastic.
Oh my God, that was, you never told me what we were actually going to see when we got there.
Yeah.
And then when we did, again, every day we keep saying you can't possibly, you know, top the day before, but you know what? It's either coming super close or it's actually happening, so.
Very cool, man. Well, I'm glad, I'm really glad you're here. I'm
Me
really
too.
Glad you're enjoying the trip. We can't leave just yet because there's something down there that you have to see.
All right, let's do it.
All right, let's go.
All right.
Okay, dude. So this is what you need to see.
Oh, man.
The Godzilla statue in front of Toho Studios.
Unbelievable. I can't believe that a little boy in elementary school from Pine Beach, who's always wanted to come to Japan and see where these films were made, that I'm actually here. This is like coming to Mecca for me.
Awesome, man. Well, here we are. Godzilla.
Godzilla. Yeah, it's just thanks so much for including me in this amazing, fantastic, and epic project.
Happy to have you on board.
You're the man.
Let's go get a drink.
Let's do it.
Sure, we wanted a beer, but the heat, the cicadas, and the impending swarm of mosquitoes were all signs pointing to, let's get out of here. Plus, our next stop was something that I'd been looking forward to the whole trip. Kaiju Sakaba, aka the Kaiju Bar. Every square foot of this place is kaiju themed. From the murals on the walls, to the fabric on the seats, the food, even the waitstaff's uniforms are based on Ultraman monsters. When you enter, the signs are clear, this bar is for monsters and their sympathizers only. No heroes allowed. We met some of our friends from Kokobunji for our final meal and somewhat of a last hurrah for our shoot in Japan.
Kanpai!
Kanpai! Yay! Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
I believe not.
So everything free.
My first tokusatsu film ever. Movie. Radon.
Oh, Radon.
I was very little. But then. Many years later, I saw Gojira 1984. When I was a kid, a small child, I watched Magmatashi.
Magmatashi.
Yeah. And Spectreman.
Yeah.
Yes, you know Spectreman?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh,
what
yeah.
What about you? First tokusatsu.
Gojira vs. Mothra.
Ah.
Vs.
Heisei? Bactra is one of my favorite kaiju designs.
Oh yeah.
Bactra, cool. Mothra, cute.
Kawaii.
Cute and cool.
Cute and cute.
Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah.
Ah.
King Ghidorah.
1991?
1954 Godzilla.
Ah.
Television. Theater was Roland Emmerich version Godzilla.
So in 2004, we saw the 1954 Godzilla.
For the first time. Original one.
Yeah.
No Raymond Burr.
Yeah. So everybody saw Godzilla King of the Monsters, which had Raymond Burr in it.
Yeah.
But yeah, we actually, this year, we saw a lot of the 1954 film in the theaters in America. So, go ahead.
The first time is 1992, Godzilla.
Good one, yeah.
Good one,
yeah.
But, yeah.
BD. TV?
Hi.
Kaiju Daisenso.
Whoa!
Yes, my first one.
Yeah.
So what was your first tokusatsu film in the movie theater?
First time is Ultraman.
Gaia to Tiga Gaia no ega atta kedo
sawatta yo. Kaiju no hoka ni nanka figure to ka so miniature to ka kyoumi ga aru n desu kedo
なんかその日本の特撮にこだわりとか、日本の特撮とか映画とか怪獣とかにこだわりとかなんかあるんですか？
Favorite? Well, the suits, suit acting, that's my favorite.
Oh,
the
yeah.
monster designs, kaiju designs, that's Ichiban.
Ichiban.
But I do like the miniatures. The miniature work in Gamera, Heisei Gamera.
Oh yeah.
Sugoi.
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 Do you saw Godzilla 2000 this year? This
yes,
year.
Yes.
What do you think about?
In my opinion, the Japanese Godzilla films and this new Godzilla film are just completely separate. This new one had some good stuff in it, but most of the best parts were the monster action.
それとなんかこうちょっと似てるなと思って、なんかこうだからなんかちょっと私は新しい感じで好きだなって思います。すごいギャレス監督の作品はすごい私すごい好きになりました。
Most of Japanese fans think that Godzilla is in tokusatsu spirit.
I do believe that that some of the people making the film absolutely wanted to make it feel like a tokusatsu experience. But I really, really, really like Toho kaiju films. So seeing the man, like a man in a suit, like with the, like actually moving around, that's what I love about those films. Why do you guys like Godzilla movies so much? What is it about Godzilla that you feel in your heart that is good? Like, it makes you want to make suits and make miniatures and continue tokusatsu.
僕は、あの、怪獣映画っていうのはものすごい、あの、豪華なおもちゃ箱みたいなものだって思ってるんですよ。ものすごく豪華なおもちゃ箱、ね、もう小さい頃からずっと見てて、あの怪獣がもし家に来てくれたらなとか、あのミニチュアを家の中にいっぱいに飾りたいなと思ってて、その夢をまだ追い続けてるから怪獣を作ったりミニチュアを作ったりしちゃうんだと思います。
Do you want the humans to defeat the kaiju or the kaiju to win?
I like kaiju win.
So what?
I like kaiju.
映画を見るきっかけになったのが、私のお母さんが特撮映画が好きで、お母さんが小さい時から見てて、大魔神とか、
大魔神
ラドとかゴジラとか、ちっちゃい時から、まあ、今だちっちゃい時から見てて、それで、まだ特撮を見るラブで、私も生まれて、捨ててから見せられて、お母さんと映画見に行って、ゴジラというものを見て、これ本当に起きてるのみたいな、ちっちゃいから本当に起きてるかどうか分かんないけど、そこからもう身近な存在じゃないけど、映画でも見て、お家でもテレビでも家でも見て、それでも身近な存在になって大好きです。
彼女と同じように小さい時から、小さい時にゴ
ジラを見て、彼はとても強いし、それで、やっぱその戦う様子がすごい好きだった。で、僕はその時に僕のお母さんに、この映画を作りたいって言ったんですよ。その時から、僕は映画監督を目指して、勉強していたんですよ。で、最初は演出をやりたかったんですけど、こちらから僕はプラモデルが好きで、模型とか作るのが好きで、その延長線上でゴジラの着ぐるみを作っていることが好きです。
Are you studying filmmaking?
Yeah.
Like learning how directors make movies?
僕はちょっと前まで、ゴジラのミニチュアを作っていた会社で働いていたんですよ。日本の特撮は今すごく悩んでいて、そのどう見ても今の日本の特撮は作り物であるっていうのが分かりすぎて、今のところ日本はリアルがないということを悩んでいます。だから今回のゴジラも、やっぱり特撮の魂が入っているっていうことを認めざるを得なかったところがあるんです。
Do you guys think that there is a future for classic tokusatsu effects in Japanese cinema?
Like、in the 日本の特撮のクリエイターたちは自分たちがやってることにすごい誇りを持ってるんですね。でもそのこだわりっていうか、俺たちが特撮を引っ張っているんだっていう思いが次の新しい世代の目を潰しちゃってるところもあるんですね。
Do you think that tokusatsu and CGI can be together and work together to make better effects?
できるものだと思いますし、それをもっとどんどんやっていかなきゃいけないと思うんですよ。
Have you seen Sakuyayo Kaiden?
I didn't see.
You didn't see?
Didn't see.
Very good. Tokusatsu and some CGI、
yeah.
blended together. Very, very good. Very good. Some of the best tokusatsu miniature work I've ever seen. And that was in like 2000, like that was like 14 years ago. Still very good. I just think overall, movies need to make sure that they use both instead of just one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you want to see more Japanese kaiju films? Yes? You should make that film. You guys should work together and make the next kaiju film. You're doing it. You're learning the effects. You're learning how to do it. Slowly, he should direct it. You guys should build the suits. Make the next kaiju film.
彼は大学で怪獣映画を作ってました。
You did?
I did.
Where is this movie? Did people like it? Was it a difficult crowd?
Yeah, so.
Eventually, I would like to see that marriage of practical effects, tokusatsu techniques, and little CGI to hide the flaws. That'd be good. But you guys really should make a new kaiju film. Do you think that Japan will ever accept more new serious kaiju films?
I hope so too. I hope.
All of this around us is all tokusatsu, and it's all your history. And actually, it's our history too as the audience members. And I just really, I celebrate it. I love tokusatsu. I love kaiju. I love Godzilla. Thank you for what you're doing and being tokusatsu fans. I'm blown away by Koko Bunji Studio. Like, I want to see more. You're going to make more, right? More suits.
Oh, more suits.
More suits.
More puppets.
More puppets.
Yeah.
More directing. More puppets?
Gambare.
Gambatta ne?
Gambatta
ne.
Okay. No problem.
Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Yo!
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Kaiju fans.
Kaiju fans.
All right.
I need to go back to this place badly. I was there for 2 hours and didn't even get a chance to look around, but from where I sat, Ultraman episodes were playing on the televisions, there were trophies on the walls, we even saw the skeleton monster Sibos making the rounds. This place was packed, and I am happy to share that it is sticking around indefinitely. We hopped on the train to head back to the hotel. It wasn't just the end of the night, it was the end of this amazing journey. Watching the Tokyo lights out the train window, I couldn't believe it was coming to a close. Each day of our visit was more incredible than the one before. Seeing how Japan celebrated Godzilla's 60th anniversary was definitely a life-changing experience. Both the statue in Roppongi and the new mural at Toho prove that Godzilla still lives large here in the heart of Japan. If you had asked me about the state of the kaiju genre, I'd have admitted that things were looking pretty grim in Japan. But now I see, in the absence of newer theatrical films being released, fans, both young and old, have been keeping these traditions alive in their own way. My passion for this fandom is what spurred me into creating the podcast, building a community for other fans to enjoy and interact with. I could not have done this without those fans. I'm amazed that people put that kind of trust in me to share my love for kaiju films. Who would have thought that giant radioactive monsters could bridge the gap across oceans and continents? I am more excited than ever for the future of this genre. So come join me, and let's see what happens next. And welcome to the Kaijucast, a bi-monthly podcast 100% dedicated to Godzilla and all of his rubber-suited foes.